I just wanted this week to tidy up a few loose ends left over from the last video we did, which you'll remember was on this idea of generic maths and having abstract static methods in interfaces. So where we were last week, we had this velocity record struct that I'd put together, and I'd implemented this I addition operators in which we defined this static abstract operator plus, which we then implemented, as you can see there, for a velocity, adding together the three dimensions that we had to it. But if you take a look at that interface that we've got here, there are a few things in there which I didn't cover. Two of them are down here, the idea of having a static virtual rather than a static abstract, and also this use of the keyword checked. So those are two new things that came in C# 11. But then the other one quickly I wanted to point out was, if you look at the declaration of the interface, which is a generic tself tother t result, we've got a constraint that says tself has to implement, and then we've got exactly that same thing again. So basically what we're saying is this interface is only allowed to be used if tself itself implements this interface. And the reason we have it like that is because of one of the fundamental rules that we have with operator overloading in C#, which is that you can only overload an operator inside the class for which that operator is defined. So what I mean is this: we could not in here do something like public static and then say velocity operator minus, and then, for example, try to subtract two integers. So we can see, regardless of how we actually implement that, that we're getting an error saying one of the parameters of a binary operator must be the containing type. And it's there for exactly this reason, so that we can't hijack this whole thing and change the meaning of minus for a built-in type like integer. So if we had one of them, velocity, being okay, and then we just need to return something, doesn't matter what. Now we can see that that's happy, because at least one of them is of the type velocity, so we're contained within ourselves. And that's basically what's happening in here, but insisting on it for the interface itself. So in fact, if I were to copy this from there so that I can edit it and just pop it in here, you can see if I remove that constraint, then here we're getting basically the same error, but this time on the interface, that one of the parameters of a binary operator must be the containing type. So that's why that's an error if we don't have that constraint in there. So it's a subtle little thing, doesn't really affect your program because you're just going to be using this interface, but it's quite a neat feature. But let's get on now to those other things, that static virtual and that checked keyword, which is a new use of an existing keyword. And let's just talk about checked in general terms to start with. So if we go back to our program, you can see what I've got here. I've just got a try catch where we'll see what type of exception we've got and see the message. And if I do something like this, if I say int val equals, and then I could say int dot max value. So the maximum possible value of an integer, we could print that out. And then what I'm going to do is something a bit odd. I'm going to say val plus plus. So we're already at the maximum value, and now we're trying to go beyond that. What's going to happen? Well, let's run that up. And to start with, we can see we get the max value, which is 2 billion and something. But then when we do the plus plus, it simply wraps around and goes to the minimum value of minus 2 billion. That's what you've got with a signed 32-bit int. And that behavior is what is known as unchecked. So when we went beyond the maximum value, it didn't report any error, it didn't do any checking for us, it just wrapped round to the minimum possible value. Now that's something we can configure in a number of ways. One thing we can do is if we go to the properties for the project and have a look down in the build, general, and then go right down here, then we can see we've got the check for arithmetic overflow. So if we check that and then run this program again, we get different behavior. So we get the maximum value, but then when we try to do the plus plus on it, we get this overflow exception, and it just tells you you've gone over the top. So that is now checked behavior. And we set that, as we saw, on the project. And if we actually have a look at what's happened inside the project file itself, we can see that it's done this twice. It's done a separate definition of that for true in both the debug circumstances and the release circumstances. Because one of the things you've got to be aware of if you have checked behavior is it can quite substantially slow down your application, because it means that on every operation on integers, it can't just do the maths, it's got to put in a check to make sure that you're not overflowing or underflowing. Even though that's going to happen only very occasionally, it's still got to check it on absolutely every operation. And so that's why something that's typically done, if you're worried about this, is we will set it to true when you're debugging. So when you're developing debugging testing, you'll catch these errors. But having hopefully avoided them with your own code, we can then set that to false for the release. So if we now run that up again, at the moment we're building debug, and so we get the exception. Whereas if I switch that to release and run it up, that's going to run quite a bit more efficiently, but we're not getting the exception, we're getting the overflow, which may cause problems. So that's a typical sort of thing that we do. However, what we also have, let's just set that back to debug, so we are checking, but you can override the project setting inside your application. So in this case, it's checked, but we could put unchecked on there, and that would mean just for this bit of code, within the curly braces of that unchecked, regardless of what the project setting was, it would never check it. So now we can see that that's overridden locally, it doesn't check it. And conversely, we can do checked, which means it will always check it regardless of what we did. So if we had it checked and we're running it as a release build, we'd still get the error being thrown. Now, all of that has been around right back since version 1 of C#. It's not a hugely well-known feature, I don't think, but it's been there for quite a long time. But what's been introduced is the idea, as we saw in here, that you can put the keyword checked actually on an operator. Now, let's see why this is important. Let's go to our velocity. And you'll notice I've put in there C as the speed of light, so just under 300 million meters per second. And let's suppose that that is our universal speed limit. So what I'm going to do inside this operator plus is I'm actually going to say var res for result equals that. And then I'm going to check that the overall speed has not become greater than the speed of light. Now, any physicists watching, you'll know this is a gross oversimplification of what happens, but let's just do this. So what we're going to do is say if res.x times res.x plus res.y times res.y plus res.z times res.z. So that is going to give us the magnitude of the velocity. You might think we then want to square root it, but we don't actually have to waste time square rooting it because we can compare that with the magnitude of the speed of light squared. So if I just see if that's greater than c times c, that will make sure that we've not gone over the speed of light and we don't have to waste time square rooting both sides. And so now if it has exceeded the speed of light, I can do a throw new overflow exception and then speed of light exceeded. Otherwise, I'll simply return that result because it's within the valid range. And so if we go back to our program now, and let's create a couple of velocities. So new velocity, and let's just make this one getting close, but not quite at the speed of light. And then let's have the other one as something a bit less, but together those two are going to exceed the speed of light. And so if I try and do a console write line of V1 plus V2, then it's getting that overflow exception because the speed of light was exceeded. If I make it a little bit less, then we can see it's still within the speed of light, so we don't have a problem there. So we can, when we are doing our own operator overloads, we can, and often we do, want to have some kind of check for the idea of overflow. But you may have already noticed that's a little bit odd because we're in a release build here, And that should mean that we are unchecked, but it's still through the exception. And even if we were to put this in as the actual hard-coded keyword unchecked, we still will get the overflow exception. So that unchecked and checked keyword and all of this, although it applied originally to built-in types like ints and doubles and that sort of thing, we didn't until C# 11 have a way of actually doing that for our own overloads. And that's what we can now do. Because in Velocity, what I can do is copy this. And on this first one, I can put the keyword checked in there. Interesting positioning. So after the keyword operator, but before the symbol. And that's saying that if there's a choice, this is the one that should get called when we're in a checked context. So that's the one that throws the exception. Whereas here, we're just going to miss that off. In fact, let's just say return there straight away. And so that's going to be the substantially quicker unchecked version that can go over the speed of light. Let's just put in a little bit of debug code. So this one is going to be the unchecked version, and this one is going to be the checked version. Notice on the unchecked version, we don't actually, and we're not allowed to, put in the keyword unchecked there. So it's either checked or it's just blank. We don't put that in there. But what we'll now see, if we go back to the program, at the moment we're in an unchecked context. So when we run that, we can see it's saying unchecked because it went through that version of the plus operator. And we can see, therefore, that it allowed us to go over the speed of light. Whereas if I simply change that, and I'm doing it in the code, but it would work if we did it on the project setting as well. If that goes to checked, we now see that it's gone into the checked version and it's got the exception because we've gone over. So that's quite a nice new feature in C# 11. The idea that we can now overload any operator we like on the basis of checked and unchecked, and actually switch on the basis of the rules the language has set up, which previously we could only do for built-in types. That also leads us on to that other feature that we had in our interface, the fact that what we've got here is we've got the static abstract operator plus, the unchecked one, and then we've got the static virtual operator checked plus. And what static virtual does, as you might expect from the name, it says this is the default implementation in the interface, but we do have the option of overriding it. So abstract, we must override it. So anyone implementing this interface must provide an unchecked one, and they can provide a checked one. But if they don't, the default implementation is there. It simply calls the unchecked version, which is the abstract one you had to provide. So if I didn't have in my velocity, if I didn't provide a checked version, then because of that default in the interface, it will just call the unchecked version even in a checked context. So here I'm in a checked context, I run that and it's still calling the unchecked version. So virtual means just what it does in most normal situations. It means that I'm allowed, if I want to leave it at the default, which will mean it'll be the same as the unchecked, or I can put a checked version in there and we get the error checking. So three features there. We had the fairly simple one, just the idea that the interface had a constraint saying that the generic type must implement that interface, and that was because of the rules of what classes you're allowed to do operator overloading in. But then we had this new idea in C# 11 that we can overload pretty much any operator where it makes sense with a checked version and an unchecked version, and so we can differentiate. We can have the slow checked version and the quick unchecked version, and that will just follow whatever the rules have been configured for the project or set up in the code. And then we also saw the idea of the static virtual method on interface that allows us to default that, so that if you don't care about the difference between checked and unchecked, you can just do it all with the one method. So hope that was helpful. Still plenty more C# 11 to come, but if you enjoyed that, do subscribe, do click like, and I'll see you next time.